topics which I have taught in the previous sessions. Okay, so now you see here, what is the packing efficiency? What I have written, I have written actually in a very simple like this: the percentage of filled space by the atoms of solid is called packing efficiency of solid. Suppose any type of solid formation is taking place and number of atoms are taking participate in the close packing. So the percentage of space filled by the spheres, okay, that you have to understand, the percentage of space which is filled by the atoms of the sphere, this is to be known as packing efficiency. Okay, and everybody knows that to calculate the percentage always it should be multiplied by the 100. So in today's session we will discuss about the how to find out the packing efficiency in terms of simple cubic. Okay, so now you see here what formula we have to use to calculate the packing efficiency. First, volume of spheres into z into 100 upon volume of unit cell. So volume of sphere, sphere volume, that is to be of always 4 by 3 pi r cube. Z, it is here the rank of piston that I have taught you in the previous session. How we find out the rank of piston? Here I am just reminding, the rank of piston z in terms of simple cubic, this is 1. In terms of FCC, this is 4. And in terms of BCC, I have taught this is actually 2. Okay? So now, divided by the unit of set and should be multiplied by the 100. This formula we will use here. Here, A represents the edge length of the unit cell. Now, Z, this is the number of atoms in the unit cell, or we can say that this is the rank of crystal. Now, so let's start to calculate the packing efficiency in simple cube. Okay? So, first of all, here I am making a figure for you that you have to understand. Let us consider this is a cube. I am trying to make a very clear figure for you that you have to try to see it properly. This is the cube. Okay, now these are the edges of the cube, like this is A, and length, breadth and height, everything is equal in the cube. Now, here you have to understand in simple cubic, one edge length that is to be formed by the contribution of two half spheres. So, how it is to be formed like this? This is to be formed like this. So, these two points are to be there and this is of the one edge length. Suppose I am considering this is the one edge length, okay, from here to here. So the radius of these two spheres, this is of the one sphere and this is of the second one sphere. So the radius which is to be considered, this is the first one and this is of the second one. So here we have got it. A is equals to, edge length is equals to, that is to be 2r. It is just double of the radius of two spheres. Now, so radius, how it is to be find out? This is to be of just half of the edge length. But this condition arises in terms of simple cubic only. Okay? In the previous session, I have told some formulas of radius for the terms of BCC, FCC and simple cubic. So that we are getting here and we will prove all the formulas during the derivation of packing efficiency of each type of unit cell. So the first radius we have got in terms of simple cubic, this is r is equals to a by 2. Okay, so now as we have to find out the packing efficiency, so we have to use the formula volume of the sphere, that is to be 4 by 3 pi r cube, that we have to write, into z into 100 upon divided by volume of unit cell. So here you have to understand how the volume of unit cell is to be calculated. Volume of unit cell, as the volume of the cube, edge length it is given here A. So the length cube that you have studied in the lower classes. So here what we have to write, A cube, or you can write it simply A cube. This becomes the volume of the unit cell. So now we have to use in the formula of packing efficiency. This is to be of 4 by 3 pi r cube into the value of z in terms of simple cube that I have taught, this is 1. Okay, now here we have to write 1 in place of z and it should be multiplied by 100 divided by, you have to use there a cube. Okay, and you can see here a is equal to 2r. So in this space you can write there pe is equals to 4, then 3 that you can write here, pi in place of pi you can do, put there 22 upon 7, r that will remain as it is, into 1 into 100 divided by 2r cube. So what you will get it in terms of packing efficiency? 4 into 22, here 3 into 7, 7 is 21, you can write there, their multiplication also, into r cube into 100 divided by 8r cube. So r cube to r cube will be cancelled, you can write there 88 divided by 21 into 100 and divided by 8. So if you will do the multiplication or divide and you will get here the packing efficiency that comes, that value, this is of 52.4%. No need to do the calculation when you are doing the derivation, but you must know that whenever these values are to be multiplied or divided, we get that value 52.4. So this is the packing efficiency of occupied space by the spheres in the formation of simple cubic. Okay, now if percentage of unoccupied space, as you have to find out unoccupied space, so how this is to be find out? 100 minus 52.4, so the value which arises in front of you, that will be of near about that if you will subtract 52.4, so that as it is 10 minus 4, 6, 9 minus 2, 7, and here again 10 minus 2, 8 it is to be there, 9 minus 5, 4. So the value you are getting, this is of 48.6%. So this will be the percentage of unoccupied space and this is the percentage of occupied space. Okay, I think you all have got it, what is the packing efficiency and how it is to be calculated in terms of simple cubic. Okay, in the next session we will study about how to calculate the packing efficiency for FCC, and till then later on, later then we will study about PCC.